Hi friends, welcome to biologyexamsforyou.com. In this video we are going to discuss about NEET biology previous questions on the topic environmental issues with detailed explanation of answers and also discussing the related questions that will help you for your exam. Let's begin. Question number 1. The high DDT concentration in aquatic food chain shall occur in. Options are A. Phytoplankton, B. Seagull, C. Crab, D. Eel. And the answer is seagull. As we know, the process behind is biomagnification. Biomagnification is the increased level of toxic compounds or pesticides at higher trophic levels in a food chain. So this is water, it is having 0.002 parts per million of DDT. Then it will be more in phytoplankton, and that is eaten up by zooplankton. Then the concentration increases up the food chain. In large fishes it will be 4.83 parts per million, and in fish eating birds like seagulls it will be 124 parts per million. So the process of increased concentration of toxic pesticides at higher trophic level, that is especially at the carnivore level, is called as biomagnification. So whenever you get a question like this, identify the top carnivore, and top carnivore will be having the maximum concentration of that toxic pesticide or toxic chemical, and the process is called biomagnification. Question number 2. Biochemical oxygen demand may not be a good index for pollution for water bodies receiving effluents from. Options are A. Domestic waste, sewage, B. Dairy industry, C. Petroleum industry, D. Sugar industry. So the question is not be a good index. So read the question carefully. As we all know, BOD is the amount of oxygen that is required by aerobic bacteria and all other microbes to decompose organic matter in an oxygenic environment at a specified temperature. Higher the BOD, the more will be the pollution. It's an indicator of pollution or organic pollution where organic waste are released. In this option, the one which is not organic waste is petroleum industry. Bacteria cannot decompose petrol. Therefore, it is not a good indicator of petroleum pollution. I would like to add one more point. The unit of BOD is mg of oxygen per liter, or it is parts per million. Higher the BOD, higher the pollution. If a water body is having high BOD, that indicates that that is polluted. Clean rivers will be having a BOD of 1 mg per liter, whereas moderately polluted rivers will be having a range from 2 to 8 mg per liter, whereas beyond 8 mg per liter, a river is considered as highly polluted. Hope you got the concept. Question number 3. Eutrophication of water bodies leading to killing of fishes is mainly due to non-availability of. Options are A. Essential minerals, B. Oxygen, C. Food, D. Light. And the answer is oxygen. Eutrophication is simply the enrichment of nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus in water bodies. If there is high levels of nutrients like nitrogen and phosphorus in water bodies as a result of running off from fertilizers or from farms, from paddy fields, then what happens is there will be algal bloom and increased growth of some hydrophytic plants. Then after that, these all decompose, and that will be decomposed by microbes that will take oxygen of other oxygen requiring organisms, ultimately killing other species of the ecosystem. You might have seen algal bloom. What will happen is it will take up more and more oxygen, so that the oxygen availability will be very less, so that other organisms in that ecosystem will suffer and will kill other species in that ecosystem due to lack of oxygen. Question number 4. A lake which is rich in organic waste may result in Options are A. Increased population of aquatic organisms due to minerals. B. Drying of the lake due to algal bloom. C. Increased population of fish due to lots of nutrients. D. Mortality of fish due to lack of oxygen. This is a question that is related to the previous question, and the answer is mortality of fish due to lack of oxygen. Whenever there is eutrophication, the ultimate result is oxygen depletion and complete disturbance of that ecosystem, killing other species in that ecosystem. Question number 5. Depletion of which gas in the atmosphere can lead to an increased incidence of skin cancers? Options are A. Ammonia, B. Methane, C. Nitrous oxide, D. Ozone. As we know, ozone layer protects the earth from harmful UV rays coming from the sun. These are the UV rays coming from the sun, UVA, UVB and UVC, of which UVA and UVC are comparatively less harmful, whereas UVB is highly harmful, which ranges from 280 to 320 nanometer. Ozone layer that is present in the stratosphere prevents the entry or minimizes the entry of UVB rays reaching the earth, thus protecting us from all diseases associated with UVB rays. Question number 6. Which of the following statements is not valid for aerosols? Options are A. They alter rainfall and monsoon patterns. B. They cause increased agricultural productivity. C. They have negative impact on agricultural land. D. They are harmful to human health. Here, read the question carefully. The question is the statement which is not valid for aerosols. As we all know, aerosols are fine solid or liquid particles that is floating in air. As a result of pollution, massive area will be covered with aerosols that can even alter rainfall and monsoon patterns in cities. It is having a negative impact on agricultural land by preventing photosynthetically active radiation or sunlight reaching the plant, so that there will be less photosynthesis, there will be less growth. It is harmful to human health also. Therefore, the answer is it causes increased agricultural productivity. It is having a negative impact on agriculture. Question number 7. Joint forest management concept was introduced in India during A. 1980s, B. 1990s, C. 1960s and D. 1970s. Answer is 1980s. These are simple memory based questions. Just want to add one or two points. Joint JFM or Joint Forest Management is actually the sustainable forest conservation involving the state forest department and local communities or villages that is in the vicinity of the forest. Ajit K. Banerjee, a divisional forest officer in Arabari Forest Range of West Bengal, initiated this project in 1980s, that is implemented further in many states like Haryana and many parts of the country. Question number 8. A river with an inflow of domestic sewage rich in organic waste may result in. Options are A. An increased production of fish due to biodegradable nutrients. B. Death of fish due to lack of oxygen. C. Drying of the river very soon due to algal bloom. D. Increased population of aquatic food web organisms. So we are getting the question continuously in the same pattern. As we know, the answer is death of fish due to lack of oxygen. More domestic sewage, it will require more decomposers or aerobic microbes that will utilize more oxygen, or it will increase the BOD, ultimately causing oxygen depletion and killing of other species of the ecosystem like fishes. Question number 9. Acid rain is caused by increase in the atmospheric concentration of. Options are A. Carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide. B. Ozone and dust. C. Sulfur dioxide and nitric oxide. D. Sulfur dioxide and carbon monoxide. The answer is sulfur dioxide and nitric oxides. So this is acid rain. Acid rain from the industrial pollution, especially from the industrial pollution or from volcanic eruptions, sulfur dioxide, nitric oxides are released that reaches the upper atmosphere where it combines with water forming sulfuric acid and nitric acid and comes along with rain as acids. Therefore, this acid can cause damages to vegetation, to water streams everywhere, even causing irritations to humans. So this is acid rain simply. The rain is slightly acidic because carbon dioxide is present, which combines with water forming carbonic acid. That is why rain is always slightly acidic, but that won't harm the organisms as such, that the acidity is very less. But when sulfur dioxide and nitric oxide are combined, then it will form sulfuric acid and nitric acid that can be toxic to the entire ecosystem or vegetation. Then acid rain also can cause severe damages to ecosystems, and also it can destroy plants, pollute water sources, even it can cause damages to buildings. Acid rain corrodes the marble or calcium carbonate of Taj Mahal, causing yellowing of Taj Mahal. So remember that point also. Question number 10. The UN Conference of Parties on Climate Change in the year 2012 was held at. Options are A. Lima, B. Warsaw, D. Durban, D. Doha. And the option is Doha. Let me add 2 to 3 points. Conference of Parties or COP is the apex decision-making body of United Nations Climate Change Framework Convention. It was formed in 1994 to stabilize the greenhouse gas emissions and to protect the Earth from threat associated with climate change. The first COP meeting was held in Berlin, Germany in 1995, whereas COP25, the last COP, that is in 2019, was in Madrid, Spain, whereas one meeting was held in India, that is COP8, that was in 2002 October at New Delhi. Question number 11. Increase in concentration of the toxicant at successive trophic levels is known as. We have already discussed. Options are A. Biotransformation, B. Biogeochemical cycling, C. Biomagnification, C. Biodeterioration. And the answer is biomagnification. Let us discuss other options also. Biotransformation is a process of making one compound, one chemical compound into another, often a toxic compound into less toxic compound, or a compound into more, making a compound into more useful compound. That process is called as biotransformation using biological agents. Biogeochemical cycling, as you all know, all the nutrients like sulfur, carbon cycle, nitrogen cycle, that cycles through earth, atmosphere, water, etc. That cycling is called as biogeochemical cycling. Then biomagnification we have already discussed, and biodeterioration is or spoilage caused by microorganisms on useful stuffs or useful materials. That can be caused by microorganisms like bacteria, fungus, etc. Question number 12. Which of the following are most suitable indicators of SO2 pollution in the environment? Options are A. Algae, B. Fungus, C. Lichens, D. Conifers. And the answer is lichen. Lichen are very sensitive to SO2 pollution. As the concentration of SO2 pollution increases, lichens starts disappearing. So, the answer is lichen. For air pollution, lichen is an indicator. Then bryophytes are also indicators of air pollution. In cities which are highly polluted, lichens and bryophytes will be absent. Question number 13. Which of the following is not one of the prime health risks associated with greater UV radiations through the atmosphere due to depletion of stratospheric ozone? Options are A. Damage to eyes, B. Increased liver cancer, C. Increased skin cancer, D. Reduced immune system. So the question is, not one of the prime health risks. As we know, UV rays, UVB rays that we have already discussed can damage skin, eyes and immunity. So can damage eyes, can cause skin cancer by causing DNA mutation, then it can reduce immune system. So the unrelated option is increased liver cancer. Question number 14. Rachel Carlson's famous book Silent Spring is related to. Options are A. Population explosion, B. Ecosystem management, C. Pesticide pollution, D. Noise pollution. The book was about DDT and associated pesticide pollution. So, a massive description on the wide use of DDT and how that affects the entire ecosystem. Or this was published in 1962, and this environmental text changed the world. Many environmental revolutions got inspiration from this book. This is a recent addition from Greta Thunberg, you might be familiar with. No one is too small to make a difference. Just remember this book also. Greta Thunberg, as you all know, an youngster, an environmentalist who is leading campaigns all over the world on protecting our planet. Question number 15. A location with luxuriant growth of lichens on the trees indicates that. We have already discussed this question. Options are A. Trees are very healthy. B. Trees are heavily infested. C. Location is highly polluted. D. Location is not polluted. And the answer is location is not polluted. Disappearance of lichens in a forest indicate environmental stresses such as high levels of SO2, NO2, etc. Bryophytes are also indicators of air pollution. Question number 16. The ozone of atmosphere in which the ozone layer is present is called. This is a very simple question. Options are A. Ionosphere, B. Mesosphere, D. C. Stratosphere, D. Troposphere. And the answer is stratosphere. Ozone is present in the stratosphere. That is from 10 to 31 miles from the surface. Question number 17. A scrubber in the exhaust of a chemical industrial plant removes. Options are A. Gases like sulfur dioxide, B. Particulate matter of a size 5 micrometer or above, C. Gases like ozone and methane, D. Particulate matter of the size 2.5 micrometer or less. And the answer is A. Gases like sulfur dioxide. A scrubber is an electrostatic precipitator which is involved in cleaning dirty air by capturing gases like SO2 and other oxides in water, water spray. So it is involved in cleaning dirty air. Question number 18. Kyoto Protocol was endorsed at. Options are A. COP6, B. COP4, C. COP3, D. COP5. And the answer is COP3, which was held in Kyoto, Japan. Let me add 2 to 3 points. The targets for the first commitment period of the Kyoto Protocol covers emissions of 6 main greenhouse gases. So Kyoto Protocol is all about preventing or reducing the emissions of greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxides, HFCs, PFCs and sulfur hexafluoride. You can remember it as GK, K for Kyoto Protocol, G for greenhouse gases. Then Paris Agreement, that is involved in combating climate change. You can remember as PC, Paris Agreement, climate change. Then the Monumental Protocol, that is Montreal Protocol, considered as the most successful environmental agreement, that is for protecting ozone layer. Montreal, MO, ozone, you can remember like that also. Preventing the production and supply of ozone depleting substances like chlorofluorocarbons. We are having good news that the ozone layer is gradually healing, and the reason is this protocol, that is this treaty, that is Montreal Protocol. Question number 19. Global warming can be controlled by. Options are A. Increased deforestation slowing down the growth of human population, B. Increasing deforestation reducing efficiency of energy usage, C. Reducing deforestation cutting down use of fossil fuels, D. Reducing reforestation increasing the use of fossil fuels. So you have to read the options very carefully. And the answer is reducing deforestation and cutting down use of fossil fuels. The reason for global warming, this is the natural global warming or greenhouse effect. The carbon dioxide that is present in the atmosphere is responsible for making this earth habitable. The radiation that is returning back to the atmosphere is trapped by this carbon dioxide that makes us this planet habitable. So think of increased concentration of chemicals that can trap heat energy. It is by our activity. By pollution, we are increasing the concentration of methane, nitrous oxide, carbon dioxide, etc. as a result of increased destruction of plants that takes up carbon dioxide. Therefore, the carbon dioxide concentration increases. And also by pollution, we are adding more and more greenhouse gases. So the concentration of greenhouse gases increases in the atmosphere indicates that it will trap more heat energy that will lead to global warming or increased climate temperature. Increased global temperature that can cause all kinds of disturbances throughout the planet. Hope you are fine with the concept. Question number 20. The Air Pollution and Control of Prevention Act came into force in. Options are A. 1985, B. 1990, C. 1975, D. 1981. Option, the answer is 1981. So these are the major acts. Wildlife Protection Act in 1972, Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act in 1974, so-called as Water Act, Forest Conservation Act 1980, Air Pollution and Control of Prevention Act in 1981, Environmental Protection Act in 1986. And that's it. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe and support this channel. Thank you so much for your support. Wishing you the very best for your exam. Please subscribe, share, and like this video.